I'm Kelly Warner. The majority of kids who have received the COVID-19 vaccine have experienced mild to no side effects, but cases of heart inflammation have been reported in a small percentage of teens and young adults. Local physicians say this should not deter families from vaccinating their kids.
There are going to be patients who are just more predisposed or more prone for whatever reason to this kind of inflammatory response related to COVID.
That's Dr. Misty Carlson, a pediatric cardiologist at Sacred Heart Medical Center, talking about the 300 cases of myocarditis that have been documented in teens and young adults who've received the COVID-19 vaccine.
And so far, the cases, again, that are in the literature, and even we've had a couple cases here at Riverbend, they've been on the mild. All we treated really with were non-steroidal anti-inflammatories, such as ibuprofen.
Myocarditis is inflammation of the heart muscle and can be caused by a viral infection, including coronavirus. Symptoms can include chest pain or pressure, palpitations or irregular heart rhythm, and shortness of breath. While it appears there is a slightly increased risk of myocarditis from vaccination, pediatrician Dr. Pilar Bradshaw says children who are unvaccinated are at a greater risk.
We know that coronavirus illness itself, the virus, causes sometimes very serious inflammation of the heart muscle. This has been part of the multi-system inflammatory condition that has killed kids. Also, the carditis has been part of the long haulers COVID.
Myocarditis should not be taken lightly. However, both Dr. Carlson and Dr. Bradshaw agree that the serious risks of coronavirus outweigh the risks of any possible effects from the vaccine, and parents should not hesitate to vaccinate their kids.
Now we know that there is this potential risk associated with it. We can identify it quickly. We have a good treatment. They're mild cases. And we definitely know what the effects of COVID are on people who aren't vaccinated. So I think when you do that risk-benefit analysis, it really points to a benefit with the vaccine, even with this potential small risk.
Learn more at eugenepeds.com/healthykids. I'm Kelly Warner.